everyone, I'm Scott Lowe with Activision, and what you just saw was Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, the next Call of Duty game from the team at Infinity Ward, and launching around the world on November 4th. As you can see, Infinite Warfare takes the series to a broad new setting, introducing new characters, a new universe, a new story. And as you can imagine, in the months ahead, we're going to be showing and talking about quite a bit, but we wanted to kick things off today with a behind-the-scenes discussion with the developers to learn more about the campaign, dive a little bit into multiplayer and co-op, as well as Modern Warfare Remastered, which you may have noticed there at the end of the trailer. That's very exciting. It's real. It's happening. And we're going to talk about it in just a little bit. And design, from that perspective?
Design director, so my job is to make sure that we are implementing all of that in-game in a way that makes the emotions, the characters come across properly. You know, I focus on visual design language, mechanics, you know, making sure that the player's experience on the stick conveys all of the emotions that Taylor's scripts and performances and everything are intended to evoke.
So the two of you actually have quite a bit of experience doing narrative-driven experiences in games, most recently at Naughty Dog before coming to Infinity Ward. What drew you to the Call of Duty franchise and this project in particular?
Well, I mean, speaking for myself, I've been a fan of Call of Duty since the beginning. I remember playing the first Call of Duty. It blew my mind. The first time I saw a dude put his back up against a wall and, like, you know, he's got his gun and he's, like, peeking around the corner. And it created so much more tension for me because I believed in the stakes of the moment. I believed that it was dangerous. And I was, that was kind of a turning point for me because I realized how important NPC performances are.
Set pieces, incredible visuals, and rock solid 60 frames per second action. And to be able to infuse our sort of narrative philosophy into that just seemed like an incredible opportunity.
What was the motivation to bring it to space, and what were kind of the opportunities there for you guys?
First and foremost, the motivation was the enthusiasm of the team. We all wanted to make this game. We could feel it in our bones. No one was going to tell us no. This was the game we absolutely wanted to make. It was the game we knew we needed to make. The opportunity to take this trademark Call of Duty feel, this boots on the ground, authentic military feel, and take it into this new setting. You know, to take, in some ways, the familiar, meaning that like gritty, authentic war feeling, and take it into a new setting was super exciting, and it was an opportunity we couldn't pass up.
The world is dependent on resources from outposts throughout the solar system. You know, Earth has been stripped of its natural resources, you know, kind of like we see today, peak oil, climate change, and now the resources that we need are out there in space. You know, it's been said that the first trillionaire is going to be whoever first mines an asteroid. So you have that sort of money out there, you're going to have war. There's going to be militarization, no question about it. So in our world, where the people and countries of Earth are reliant on these outposts for the fuel and other resources that they need, there's a brutal, insurgent, militarized group called the Settlement Defense Front that rises to attempt to take control of all of these resources. The Settlement Defense Front is this brutal fascist group that wants to completely control all of the outposts throughout the solar system and to essentially hold the countries of Earth in a stranglehold by virtue of having a complete control and embargo on all of the resources that the people of Earth need to survive. Dogfighting in space, in a convertible space fighter that switches between zero-G and atmospheric combat. And of course we have all of the boots-on-ground combat that you're used to on Earth, but then we also have the experience of fighting in zero-G, you know, grappling around the outside of a ship that you're trying to board. And we have, you know, for instance, a mission where you are on the surface of an asteroid spinning out of control close to the sun, where it's 2,000 degrees in the sunlight and negative 200 degrees in the shade. And you have to be focused not only on the guys in front of you and creating cover there, but also you need cover against the sun so you don't get fried by it. So it creates these new gameplay challenges and these new pressures on the characters that are totally unique to Infinite Warfare.
With your crew, you know, how are you guys bringing these characters to life? I mean, we're here on this performance capture stage. It's not just a pretty set. Like, it's something you guys are actively using, right?
No, we've been shooting for a little over a year now. We don't just kind of get everyone together and shoot over a few days. We like to look at our production more like shooting on a episodic TV series. We have actors that are committed to working on this project with us from beginning to end. And as we get to know the characters better, as we get to know the actors better, we can tailor those performances and those roles to who, what's really true about the character for them. And so we've got a shoot here tomorrow, actually, one of our last shoots in the game. But it's been incredible to have this facility, because what it allows us to do is, it's, as you can hear, it's incredibly quiet here. It's a perfect space. And so we can capture each actor's movements, their voices, their facial expressions, all in at one go. And it allows these characters to really be in these scenes and acting and listening and responding to each other in a very natural, believable way. Also, we think that our voiceovers in this game are going to be much more realistic, because we don't do any voiceovers in a recording booth, where an actor is sort of forced to sit on a stool in front of a giant microphone, and they can't move too much because it changes the acoustic properties of their voice too much. Instead, we have wireless microphones and, again, these helmet-mounted cameras capturing their expressions, and they're able to run around the space. They're able to throw themselves into cover. They're able to grab a gun and shout that, you know, a grenade is coming, or crawl up next to each other and whisper because we're doing a stealthy infill. And again, I think that's really going to transport the player into this universe really effectively.
Hey guys, I'm Brian Bloom. I play Captain Nick Reyes, your player character. And today we're going to get a sneak peek behind the scenes at some performance capture footage from the all-new upcoming Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. This is a scene I wrote with Jake and Taylor, where Captain Reyes and Staff Sergeant Omar are planning a mission to go behind enemy lines and scout an LZ for reinforcements. Here at the Infinity Ward motion capture stages, we created some incredible, amazing characters that should be memorable and add to your gameplay experience. So without further ado, let's take a look at some raw performance capture video from Call of Duty Infinite Warfare.
You been down to Titan?
I have.
Ops?
No. Pops. Dad was a tank farmer. Worked the pipelines for about 30 years. Retired just before the SDF took it over.
Let's go give him hell.
Bet your ass. This has been a long time coming.
How are we executing?
Joint operation? You and me. Our copy.
Affirmative. Armed recon? Small team. We're invading a denied area.
Yeah, silver lining around that reticle is SecDef didn't ask permission then, and we're not asking permission now.
My jacks are already standing by.
You just do what you did at the gateway. We'll zip this place right up.
Proud to be a service, Sergeant.
Pride is 100% bona fide bullshit, Raze. You just make sure the mission comes first.
Copy that. Sir, the Sergeant is well aware that the word proud is right in the Navy creed.
I knew there was something I didn't like about you sons of bitches. That explains the white uniform and the submarines.
Submarines?
Yeah. Only the Navy could build a ship designed to sink.
Let's gear up and get evil.
Sure thing.
I mean, as a designer, that's really opened the floodgates for us. Like, we're not kind of chained to modern. We can kind of make new toys, create new mechanics, and we can take players to places they've never been before. You know, we have some really good multiplayer maps that take place on Earth, but we also have a multiplayer map up in a space station. We have multiplayer maps on other planets within our solar system. So just being able to kind of bring players, or have the opportunity to bring players there, is just really exciting for us. We also have kind of new mechanics, you know, new mechanics I can't talk about right now, but we have kind of a whole new stable of lethals and tacticals for the player to kind of engage with and to try, and you're going to see some of that in our upcoming trailers, and it's pretty spectacular.
Well, speaking of the trailers, we saw a little bit, you know, on the campaign side, you know, these, you know, zero-G dogfights and these, like, you know, ship-based battles. Is that coming into multiplayer at all, or is it mainly still on that kind of person-to-person combat?
We always share, like, we work closely with the campaign team, and they work closely with us, so, like, a lot of tech went into the Jackal and the flying, and we have that tech in MP, but we're very, very careful to preserve the core of what makes Call of Duty just the best shooter out there. We, you know, our team plays a ton of Black Ops 3, you know, we watch it on the CWL, and we've gotten to build off of kind of their map design and what they learned. So it's really, I think, hitting the mark, and it is future, but it's still the Call of Duty that you love.
Well, I'm pleased to announce that for the first time ever, Infinity Ward is doing zombies. So I've got a really experienced team, awesome team working on this. You know, we've done Chaos Mode as a team for Modern Warfare 3 with Joe's help. And then we did all the whole Extinction series from Ghosts. And, you know, now we're all super big fans of zombies and all the things that both Sledge and Treyarch have done with zombies and Raven in the past. And so we're taking that, and we're excited that we're able to kind of finally do our own take on zombies. And it's its own completely different universe. It's a separate universe from what Treyarch's doing. It's a separate universe from Infinite Warfare. We have something like truly unique and different, and people haven't seen before. And I think, you know, I'm sure that the fans are going to love it.
Well, speaking of the fans, if there's one thing I know about zombies fans, they are ravenous, and they go crazy for Easter eggs. I know it's a big priority for Extinction and some of your other work, but is that something you're embracing as well for zombies?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, we just scratched the surface on Extinction, but in zombies, I mean, we love the Easter eggs. We love, you know, it's what gives the game life on YouTube, you know. And what's step 21 of getting this particular weapon quest? You know, people love that stuff. It really drives, like, replayability as well, and so, you know, being such a big fan of the work that the other studios have done with Easter eggs, we're taking it even one step further and can't be more excited. And it'll be interesting to see how many of the Easter eggs fans, you know, actually find and how long it takes them to find these things.
Awesome. Well, I understand you actually have a little something you could show today.
I do. Yeah. I have an image we're going to show now.
Yeah, I mean, we were really inspired by the community. There's been a voracious outpouring for a remastered ever since, you know, the new console generation came along, and this year we're able to do it. We're working very closely with Raven. We're executive producing and overseeing the game. You know, personally for me, just being a fan of the franchise, I'm thinking back, you know, Taylor had mentioned that Crew Expendable was one of his favorite levels. I love that opening too, but my personal favorite was All Gillied Up. I think
mine
Joe
as well, yeah.
Yeah, that was Joe's personal favorite. We were talking,
I like One Shot, One Kill.
Yeah, One Shot, One Kill, which I love too, because that was, you know, you started in All Gillied Up, you're in this stealth mode, you're sort of creeping through the weeds, and then you get to the end of that level, and then all of a sudden you're in One Shot, One Kill, where this is like brutal firefight and near a Ferris wheel, and I remember just like throwing my controller in frustration, and I'm looking forward to that experience again because it was really rewarding when I got through it, and it's going to be awesome to play again.
Well, I got to tell you, looking at the footage, just what little bit there was there at the end of the trailer, it looked incredible. What is some of the work that's going on behind the scenes to kind of bring it into this new console generation?
Yeah, Raven's really amping up everything. They went back and, you know, we're sticking true to the core original vision of the game, but they're looking back at the textures and reworking those completely from the ground up to make them have that fidelity that you expect from current console generations. It's going to look vibrant. It's going to look brilliant. It's going to look like something amazing when you play this game. Also, the sounds are being reworked. There's audio rework being done, revamping all that. There's new Foley that was recorded. Different things like that, especially new techniques too. Since 2007, the game came out, which is
hard to believe it's been that long. Yeah.
9 or 10 years, which is crazy to think about. And you know, there's a ton of techniques. So like dynamic lighting's been worked in, new visual effects, you know, just a lot of processing and a lot of you know, new tech that's been pushed on there.
Yeah, well, we've talked a lot about the campaign, and we all have our, like, you know, like, kind of marquee moments, but, of course, multiplayer was a huge component. How does that factor into Remastered?
Yeah, multiplayer was one of my favorite things to do, too. It sort of revolutionized multiplayer for the games industry at large. It was this new experience that was remarkable. And what you're going to get with Modern Warfare Remastered is you're going to have 10 multiplayer maps, some of fan favorites. You know, Crash was one of my personal favorites.
Backlot, yeah.
Yeah, Backlot. So you'll have, you know, some really awesome maps to play on. And then you're going to have your prestige, your kill streaks, all the progression stuff you remember too, and familiar modes and things like that. So you're going to have a good multiplayer experience. It's going to be really killer. To call that ballin', doing this is my calling. Flow is so appalling. My phone off and she calling. I'm like, yeah, what it do? Penthouse, man, what a view. Fall back because I'm coming through with my whole team. They coming too. That's real. Too real. Motherfucker, tell me how you feel. I'm too good for my own good. I won't leak the album, I let it spill. Number one, bitch, I bet it will. Do the numbers, I said it will. I played the game and I'm still the same. And I never change just to get a deal, bitch, I'm ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing.